Alright guys, so this video is going to focus on how to find the missing angles when you're given a few lines, maybe a shape or something like that involved. And we're going to use different relationships that we know about angles in order to fill in the missing pieces here. So when I talk about relationships with angles, I may be talking about vertical angles, corresponding angles, alternate interior angles, and things of that nature. So just to kind of refresh just a little bit here. So the kind of situation that we're going to be dealing with is when two parallel lines are cut by a line, which is called a transversal. There's certain relationships that are kind of understood if we're given this situation. When we have two parallel lines and a line cut through it, we can then apply alternate interior angles, corresponding angles, and things of that nature. And then vertical angles and supplementary angles are always going to be there. So hopefully you do know or at least have some kind of a background when it comes to understanding these kind of angles here. So we're trying to fill in the missing pieces for angle X, angle Y, and angle C is what we're trying to figure out here. So I'm going to start with angle X. And if I'm looking at angle X, well, first off, one thing that we do need to understand is this top and bottom line over here, these two are parallel lines. And if these are parallel lines, then we're going to be able to use the relationship that I just mentioned over here about using corresponding and alternate interior angles. So I want you to kind of picture that these lines go clear across here. And for this left side over here where the 65 and the X is, so this diagonal line that we have there is going to act like our transversal cutting through. So what that's going to let us do here is that if that 65, that's hanging out up there. All right, so I'm going to use the relationship of alternate interior angles. So interior angles are angles on the inside here. So where this X and over here is and the 65 and the one on the other side would be interior angles. Alternate interior angles are ones like opposite each other. So 65 and then this space over here would be considered alternate interior angles. And what we know about alternate interior angles is that they are the same. So if this angle over here is a 65, then I also know that this bottom left angle over here is also a 65. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this parallel line down here, this straight line here. So one thing that we do got to keep in mind is that a straight line or a supplementary angle is equal to 180 degrees. So that means this entire straight line, any angles within there are 180 degrees. So if I take this straight line here, right, here's my straight angle. Everything within this straight line here, kind of like a little semicircle there, every angle inside of there has to equal 180 degrees by definition of a supplementary angle. And inside that supplementary angle, I have that 65 that we just got from the alternate interior angles, plus that X that we're trying to figure out. So that 65 plus that angle X have to equal 180 degrees. All right, so all we have to do is solve this little equation here, or just realize, hey, 65 plus X is equal to 180 degrees. So really, all I have to do is subtract 65 degrees from 180, and it's going to give me that missing piece. So if I take the 180 and subtract 165 from it, I get 115. All right, so that tells me that angle X is 115 degrees. Now we're going to work on finding angle Z. I'm going to go ahead and start with angle Z over here. And we're going to be able to find angle Z kind of by the same relationship that we just talked about with angle X. If I'm looking at angle Z, angle C falls on this parallel line here as well. So this straight line that we have here is also a supplementary angle. So that means that angle Z all the way across over here, including that angle 80 that we have there, this makes up a supplementary angle. So technically I have angle Z plus that angle 80 there, and they have to equal 180 degrees by definition of a supplementary angle. So if the entire thing, if both of these angles here together equal 180 degrees, but I know that this particular piece here is 80 of it, well, if I take 180 and I subtract 80 from it, it's going to give me the remaining piece there. So that means that angle Z is 100 degrees there. May not look like it from the picture. I always say when it comes to math, never trust the images, trust the numbers there, because the images may not always be drawn the scale there. But if we know that both of those together equal 180 and we subtract the 80, we are left with 100 degrees there. All right, so now we're going to work on finding angle Y. And when we're going to be taking a look at angle Y here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to redraw these parallel lines, and I'm just going to kind of stretch these out a little bit to kind of just help us see our picture here. I'm also going to do the same for our diagonal line that we have there. And we're again going to be using our relationships with the parallel line when a transversal is cut through it. And what we're going to be doing is we're going to be looking at these angles that are created on this right-hand side of our figure here, specifically alternate interior angles, because I'm given that this bottom right angle over here is 80 degrees. And if I look at the alternate interior angles, well, for 80 degrees there, its alternate interior angle would be angle Y. These are alternate interior angles to each other. And as I mentioned earlier, alternate interior angles are congruent to each other. They equal each other. So if this angle down here is 80 degrees, that means angle Y must also be 80 degrees. So by using supplementary angles, alternate interior angles, we are able to fill in the pieces for the missing angles of this figure. We just need to maybe extend some lines here so that we can kind of fully see the picture and what's going on with it. Otherwise, that is it for this video.